I was the best in the league, Elliot. Nobody opened the door better than I did.
Now we've got a couple of Sabres in the box on the far side, Ruttu and Ray.
Okay, this was the door of the home penalty box here at the Odd. Where is it now, Rob?
It's upstairs in my office, actually. I was a group gave it to me after the building was closed and put it on a nice metal stand for me with a plaque to say what it was and presented it to me. They figured that I'd gone in and out enough that I'd kind of grown attached to it, so they thought I should have it.
There are two Sabres in the box.
The signature moment in Memorial Auditorium history was May 20th, 1975, the Fog Game, Game 3 of the Stanley Cup Final. Jim Lorenz killed a bat with his stick that day while Robert scored the winner.
Farrell coming to center, dumps it off the boards in the corner. Robert going after it, he scores!
People say, how'd you do that? Pure luck. I mean, there's no need to lie about it. I could try probably 100,000 times over and over. It was just meant to be that night that the puck was to go in. When we played the Russians and beating Montreal in overtime here and so on.
You scored that goal.
I did.
On the face of a quick
score! I was lucky to score them, yeah. it's just got a special place in my heart. Every time I go to HSBC, I always live here.
Ruff's greatest moment was a four-goal night against the Nordiques.
Back into Vanderchuk. Here's Chad for Ruff for goal number four.
Oh, it was awesome. It was awesome. I'll never forget. You know, standing ovation, and I still remember the three stars and coming out for that, and Mike Ramsey being out there, and he was one of the stars, and high-fiving, and I put some fedora on that some fan had thrown on the ice, and I threw that up in the air, and as I turned and came back, I caught it, so everything was going good that night.
The Sabres are still one of the NHL's most popular teams, but leaving the Odd ended a powerful era in the city's history.
But I remember that last night. It was a pretty sad time, you know, playing Hartford, and, you know, I got thrown out partway through the game, and, you know, I got to sit in the dressing room with, you know, Gilbert Perreault and Rick Martin and all the older guys that have, you know, played their whole career here and expended a lot more time in this building than I did. And, you know, listening to their stories, that, getting kicked out of that last game was kind of a downer, but it was pretty cool sitting there listening to those guys the last night and seeing how they actually really felt about it.
I guess that when you come back in here, it makes you appreciate what was given to you. It's been a great life, and it's just sad to look at the way the building has been let go.
2 weeks ago, the city announced fans will be able to buy the beloved blue seats, but little else will remain. The plan is to turn out the lights and begin demolition in October.
Wonderful memories from the old auditorium, Memorial Auditorium here in Buffalo, New York. You see the scene at Ralph Wilson Stadium as we all bundle up and the wind insults the face and we wonder how bad's it going to get. The snow is really, the wind's swirling, the snow's coming down, but they say it's about 20 minutes that this major disturbance or squall will be in the area, and then that should start to work its way out of here and we'll catch a break. Right now, Dan Craig sending the Zambonis onto the ice. The warm-up has concluded for the game. Puck drop, as mentioned, is about 24 minutes away at 1:22 ET. Donald S. Cherry getting ready for the opening here in the coach's corner and his nice digs there. We'll see Don next on Scotiabank Hockey Tonight.
My mom doesn't really know you.
No, we just met.
Why does she want a second onion from you?
Actually, your mom wants a second opinion on her investments.
Oh. Yeah.
Sorry, office.
We were just talking onions.
Wherever your investments are, get a second opinion. A free no-obligation review to make sure you're invested in what's right for you. You're richer than you think. Scotiabank.
CBC's Hockey Night in Canada and Kia Motors want to make a winner out of you. What's up for grabs? A new truck. Choose your dream team and enter CBC's Hockey Night in Canada Fantasy Pool, presented by Kia. You could drive away in a new 2008 Kia Sorento. Go anywhere, anytime. Tune in each week to see who's in the lead. Register online and track your team's progress. CBC's Hockey Night in Canada Fantasy Pool, presented by Kia. The power to surprise.
In the most demanding climates of the world, humans have adapted to walking on ice and snow. Fitting over your existing footwear, Winter Trax and Yak Trax will help you walk steadier, navigate slope sidewalks, and make you feel safer this winter. Yak Trax Pro for heavy active use, Yak Trax Walker for recreational use, or Winter Trax for light use. Yak Trax, designed for walking the roof of the world, made for walking your neighborhood. To order Yak Trax or find a store near you, call 1-800-663-8613 or visit yaktrax.ca.
This Saturday, we're on the air with Philadelphia, Toronto. Tampa's at Ottawa. Actually, Tampa into Toronto tonight. And the New York Rangers at Edmonton. Game two of our doubleheader, starting with Scotiabank Hockey tonight at 6:30 Eastern. Senior VP for the NHL, Director of Hockey Ops, Colin Campbell, will get a kick out of this. Ty Conklin, who played the Heritage Classic in Edmonton. Here he is walking out in Buffalo. And the same guy behind him, who also, of course, played at Commonwealth Stadium, George Larocque.
Big
George.
That was cold. That was real cold.
There was a shot I wish I had out of you and the commissioner, Gary Bettman, who's going to sit right over here in row 47, brave guy with his son, Jordan. But, yeah, it was unbelievable. Stamp here, though, and it's – are you worried?
We worried? Well, I want to get out of here before we – if we have to cancel this. And I don't know who's going to tell 70,000 people to go home, but I think this is great, and just hopefully we can get it in.
Well, Dan's just in behind us. Dan Craig, of course, the facilities operations manager for the league, and he seems pretty confident. I was telling you, it sounds like 20 minutes, and the worst of this will be through the Buffalo area. What have you told the players, Colin, about preparing for the risks of a game like today?
Well, we've talked mostly to the managers and the coaches, and a lot of this stuff you can discuss in boardrooms, but you can't really deal with it until it happens. So we have a lot of issues in place or situations in place that if we've got a scrape, we'll stop it and scrape. It'll take us about 4 minutes to do a dry scrape. There's a lot of, we've talked to the officials, they'll be the people we'll be dealing with on the ice. And but as you can imagine, there's all kinds of things that we're ready for. And if it stays like this, I think we've all played in this kind of weather once in our life, if not more than that.
Mark Jonette and Don Van Mazenhoven, so they'll look and see if it's getting a little too snowy, because it is tough. I was saying earlier, Ryan Smith coughed up the puck, tried to bounce pass it off the boards, and it just dug into the snow, and he was dead. Rive scored on a power play after he took a hook. Physicality or, you know, the intensity of a game, would you say, look, guys, give yourselves a break, or can you do that to an NHL regular?
We haven't mentioned that at all. In fact, I didn't find a lot of animosity. Maybe we don't like that, but I didn't see a lot of animosity in the Edmonton game. Edmonton, Montreal, I think they were just having a great time. So we'll see what happens. I just think when you come to a place like this, it's hard to really feel it unless you're here. I think the players are loving it right now. And the only thing I saw in warm-up, the ones without the visors were squinting a lot. The one with the visors were doing it, they seem to be doing okay.
No doubt, skating from north to south. Well, good luck with it all today. It is wonderful. As you say, electric. You can hear the crowd going in behind us. Elliot, I think you have something for us. What's up?
Yeah, I'm with Maxim Talbot and Marc-Andre Fleury. Guys can't play today, but seem pretty excited. What did you think watching the warm-up?
Looks pretty fun. You know, it's just like all the time when we're young, just, you know, snowing outside and just having fun outside.
Maxim?
I'm jealous. I mean, we're hurt right now, both the high-angle sprain and the... I mean, we wish we could play. It's so exciting. I had a chance to skate yesterday, and it's an amazing experience for all the players. And, you know, it's really great memories for everyone, I think.
Would you give Ty Conklin any advice? Did you talk to him about it? Because he's played in one of these before, but did he talk to you much about what it's like to play goal in this?
I don't have any tips to give him, but I'm sure, like you said, he played already, so he knows a little bit what to expect. I think just stay warm, wear some layers of clothes, and just try to sit it back to the snow.
All right, thanks very much, guys. Enjoy the game. Ron?
Thank you.
Facilities operations manager for the NHL, Dan Craig. I know you got your hands full here, Dan, but tell us how you're making out.
It's pretty good. We backed off just at the right time on the snow to get a good resurface for the warm-up, and now it sucked it back in here again, so we're going to do a couple of quick light floods and see if we can get this thing trimmed up to get the game going.
Maybe, Mark Punga, if you get down to ice level, you can see that it's almost like a curling surface right now, all that bevels.
It pebbles up, and that's the problem right now. We don't want to get the surface too cold because then it'll crack. So what we're going to do is we just do it very lightly so we double up on our resurface and cap it up, and then we're ready to go.
We are still about 22 minutes away from puck drop, so you've got that going for us. One last thing. All your hard work here, the hours of putting up the boards, putting in the ice, that comes from your dad's work ethic. So why don't we say hello to him?
Yeah, I want to say hello to my mom and dad. Dad, happy birthday. Happy 80th birthday in Three Hills, Alberta. I love you. See you soon.
Not nice. And Mark, one other shot over here, Danny. The other ice you built today was for the kids. These are Hasek's heroes. Dominic donated $1 million.